the most beautiful place in the world, where a Tar Heel blue sky blankets Murphy on its way to the Tennessee border. It's a long way from Raleigh and the Outer Banks, but we're living in Carolina too. In fact, you might call it extreme Carolina. With more, here's Michael Borkman.
Welcome everyone to Extreme Carolina, a show that focuses on great people with great stories who prove in their everyday lives that anything is possible. We strive to bring you relatable life lessons from interesting and inspiring people as they live out their purpose on this earth. Folks, get ready. It's time for some good news you can use. We got some here today because we have one awesome, amazing young lady that we were able to finally get her and corral her to be on the show. And we're just so honored and grateful and thankful to get her here. So we don't want to waste a whole bunch of time, but her name is Stacy Leppard. She's an amazing lady, mom, wife, friend, churchgoer. She's all kind. And even on top of all of that, she runs an organization that is tough to do. I mean, it is so tough that it will try even the saintest of people. You know, and so we're just so grateful that she does what she does in our community. So without any further ado, let's just bring and give Stacy Leppard a warm, happy Extreme Carolina welcome. Welcome you, Stacy.
Thank you so much. Good to be here.
We are glad to have you here. It is amazing. So let's jump right into this thing.
Yeah.
I mentioned about you being a wife and, you know, and a mom and stuff like that. And I'm sure the folks say, yeah. And then when I brought up she also heads up an organization called the Rock Bottom Recovery. Let me ask you something about that.
Yeah.
Is that a 501c3 or is just something you're doing?
Yes.
So it is definitely a legit thing that she's doing.
It is legit.
So the government, you know, whenever someone wants to donate or give anything to this 501c3, it's legit because it is a little 501c3, but let's just say this focused on, if someone wanted to give to your organization, how would they go about doing it? I mean, do they find you on the street? You got a website?
They can give a check. They can give cash. We give receipts to everybody if they want them for tax purposes at the end of the year, because it is 100% tax deductible. And, you know, we typically have fundraisers every year. And this year or last year, we weren't able to have one because of COVID. But that's where we get a lot of our funding is from our fundraisers. Huh? And private donations are very much appreciated. But we don't get those that often. So we really rely on our fundraisers. But they can mail a check. They can stop by my work. They can Venmo Rock Bottom. Rock Bottom has their own Venmo account, so it's not hard.
No, they can find you. They're looking for you.
They can find me. I might be hard to get stopped, but I'm not hard to find.
Yeah, well, folks, that we'll ask her again at the end of the show on how you can send money, bring money, or just if they want to volunteer, whatever it is, case may be, we'll ask that at the end of the show.
Okay.
Now, speaking of Rock Bottom, now, help us out here. How did this just come to be? Because it looks like you have a lot going on with job, mom, and wife, and all this other stuff. How did Rock Bottom come to be?
It was, I started Rock Bottom January 17th, 2017. And that was after I had found recovery after 16 months of me going through my own recovery. There was nothing here where I live in Hayesville, North Carolina. And I just had been praying and seeking God about what I could do, because I knew that if I had been hurting as bad as I was, other people were hurting. And we live in a small community, but drugs are very prevalent in the area, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to be the person that I needed whenever I was sick in substance use. So there you go. That's how it was formed.
Awesome. Okay. So it's not something that you saw happening over there and said, hey, you know what? I think those folks need some help. I think I'll do what I can to help out, even though you said part of that a moment ago. But you have history. You know what you're doing. It's not something you read in a book. I mean, this is something that you went through. And when you're trying to help somebody and they're giving you this line, yeah, Miss Stacy, but.
Yeah, I know.
And Miss Stacy done been there and done that.
Yes, many times.
So when you were there in the midst of that, that's how you came to be, because it's not easy. And I'm sure you tried to hide that for a long time. And you didn't want people to know that side of you. And but then there came a point where it didn't even matter anymore.
It's we can't hide it. When you're in substance use, it's just a matter of time before your whole life falls apart. I mean, it's not something that can be well hidden. Yes, there are people that can think they can function, but eventually it's all going to end. I mean, there's nothing good that can come of substance use, period. Mm. You will be found out.
So in a case, so you had an instant in your life where you sort of hit bottom. You were bottoming out. That you were just, it was in your life, it was in you, and you had pretty much lost everything you ever cared about at that point.
And that's what addiction does.
Wow.
Yeah.
And the ones who just doing this occasional, oh, I just smoke a little bit on the weekend. Oh, I just drink a little bit at, you know, functions here and there. Mm-hmm. That could be true. But there is a time when you go past that. And you go into something else. What advice do you have for people that are just weekend warriors type people or just casual drinkers?
I say be very cautious, because addiction is no respecter of persons. It can hit anybody at any given time. You may have a drink one weekend and be able to put it down, but there might come a time whenever you can't put it down. So I don't see the point. And if you say you're just using on the weekends or you're just drinking on the weekends, that's a problem.
Within itself,
it's a problem. You know, and I think there's a lot of that happens, but, in my case, I never remember a time like I would, drink on the weekends and when I was younger, and we could put it down through the week, and then it became to where I couldn't put it down. But there was never a time that I ever just had a casual drink. I always would get drunk. I can never tell you a time that I just had one glass of wine or one mixed drink or one beer. It was, I always got drunk. Always.
Mm. That is, and that is you being transparent as you could possibly be.
Yeah, it's the truth. I mean, we have to own our addict. We have to own it. And unless we're honest, there's no need in even honesty is the top, I would say, character trait that is needed in recovery. Without honesty, you're not going to move forward, period. And our stories, you know, it's like I tell people, yes, we all have war stories. They're a little bit different, but truly they're all the same, because we all end up losing the things that we love the most, and we're fighting for our lives to get back our life. It is a day-to-day process.
Wow. I mean,
recovery is a process. You never reach the end. It's a process that you go through.
Right.
So you stay
on guard pretty much all the time.
Yeah, you have to. And you have to walk in honesty and integrity. You have to.
That is amazing. Now, I want to come back to a day in the life of Stacy, you know, and just a day in the life. I want to come back to that. But before I get to that, I want to, you know, let folks know just a little bit more about you, because what we do, we try to find out a little bit about our guests. It's easy to ask them what they do, how long they've been doing it, and this and that. But we like to also know, well, just a little bit, well, what do you do when you're not doing that, such as reading? We always like to ask our guests, what book have you read recently that had the biggest impact on you and why?
Well, I have not read a book, and I can't even tell you when.
Oh, my goodness.
Because I literally have not had time to just sit down and read. It has. Okay. I would love to be able to just sit down and read a book.
Well, that.
Lately, it's been a couple years since I have actually got to sit down and read a good book.
Well, and I do know that you're truthful on that. We met, I think we've been knowing each other now probably about 2 or 3 years, maybe a little bit longer than that. And I had you on another one of my shows before. And I remember asking you the same question. And then at that time, you had read a book. And I think the name of it was Same Kind of Different as Me.
I think that's the last book I read. And my son had to read it for school. He had actually had two books he had to read. And so I was reading that one while he was reading the other one. It was the best book. It was based on a true story. Mm-hmm. I'd actually probably read it again, but yeah, it was a really good book.
Yeah.
Now I do my studies. Like I read the Bible, of course, daily. Right. And then I do my Bible studies. But to sit down and have read just a book is not, that's been the last book I've read.
Okay. That's fine. I mean, you know, because really it's so important to educate ourselves, not just about what we do. I love the fact that you said you do not just read the Bible, but you do Bible studies. And so, and that is key. You have to study that thing because you can't just pick it up and read a little bit and lay it down.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, that'll work.
Now, if you're going to get something out of it, you get to read it, you know, more than once and have a particular study. Now, and that's fine. Now, I don't mean, you know, try to embarrass you or anything like that.
No, not at all.
And I just like to ask that question. But also, we also like to ask, and this one, I know you know what this one is. It's advice. And we like to ask each person, what's the best advice that you've ever received in your entire life?
The best advice I have ever received was, not really sure if you would call it advice, but it put a different perspective for me. Was I was told one time that my current situation was not my final destination. And that is something that I actually tell a lot of people, because it was had such an impact on me. Mm-hmm. That my current situation was not my final destination. If you would have asked me 6 years ago, or if you would have seen me 6 years ago, and see where God has brought me today, it's like that rings so true, you know, through a lot of hard work, determination, and turning my will over to God, saying, okay, God, you do with me what you want. Not what Stacy wants anymore, because I'm messing things up terribly, but what do you want? And when we do that, then we let him have back the driver's seat, then things start working out. It just kind of,
That is some, you know, now you can put that in there of advice. I mean, because that is so, so perfect.
Yeah,
because none of us is going to be where we are today 3 years from now.
Right. You know, we shouldn't be if we're still growing.
Well, and even if we're not growing, we're either going to be better than we are or worse than we are.
Right, exactly.
We're never going to stay where we are. You know, that's just not going to happen.
I never want to stay where I am because that means that I'm stagnant. I'm not growing. I want to grow. I want to step out afraid and do things afraid because that's where I grow. That's my own personal thing. Like if I can do something afraid, then mm-hmm. I know I'm going to grow from it.
Hmm.
So over the last 4 years that I've been doing Rock Bottom, I've had to face a lot of fear.
Right.
And I have, by the grace of God, I have grown in areas that truly I needed to grow in. And I'm still growing. I will be growing for as long as there's breath in me. I don't think I will ever achieve all the things that I want to in this lifetime.
You know, that's really, really cool and very important. That you look at the people that you're helping, that actually, and you turned it around, it shows you where you could have been had you stayed where you were. And, sure. But through the grace of God, as you said, you know, God had a better work for you to do. You yeah. know, it wasn't for you to be sitting there at the bottom of a bottle. You know, drunk is all get out, not knowing which way right. that your family then wrote you off and all this and that. Mm-hmm. God has something for you to do. And you are making a difference in people's lives today. And if folks don't know about Rock Bottom, they need to find out about it. You don't have to be a drunk or smoke all kinds of pot to find yeah. out about Rock Bottom. I mean, you guys even have like a weekly meeting or something like that.
We do. Right? We meet every Monday night, 7 to 8 at the Senior Center in Hayesville, 196 Ritter Road. Mm-hmm. And then we have one-on-one meetings. If somebody needs a one-on-one meeting, of course, I work a regular job.
Yeah.
In addition to Rock Bottom, I can meet an hour before the meeting or typically that's what I like to do. Or on a Friday mm-hmm. from 8 till 2, actually about 1:30 because I have to be in the jails at 2. But typically 8 to 1:30, I block that time off. So if somebody's needing some one-on-one peer-to-peer support, mm-hmm. then I do that. We don't just help people in addiction. We help their families as well and friends that don't know what to do.
Right.
That don't know how to respond or engage with the person that is lost in addiction. So if you've been affected by addiction, we're there to step up and help you.
Wow. And all of us have been affected by it, whether it, mm-hmm. it be in our family or in our friend's family.
Yeah.
Somebody we know has been affected, which means indirectly affects us. So how do we deal with that person? And I love the fact that you said you give help to the families of those people. And they come to you and say, hey, I just don't know what to do. I'm at my wit's end. It's driving me crazy. I just have yeah. no idea what to do. I love them and I want to keep them in my life, yeah. but I can't have them. You know, they steal everything I got. They do this and yeah. that. It's crazy.
Yeah. Their pain is so real. And the only difference is they're having to go through all this trauma and pain sober. And we're the ones that's going through it self-medicating. So they're the ones that's really experiencing the brunt of everything.
That is amazing. Somebody somewhere is praying for that person.
Yes.
They want that person to come out of it because prayer does amazing things. I mean, you know, this is not the Michael Bortman prayer hour, but, you know, or the Extreme Carolina prayer hour, but we do like to shine the light on whatever's going on. And yeah, what's going sure. on is the fact that you're stepping up in people's lives. I mean, you're completely stepping up. Just when you said you go to the jails, I think you said you blocked that off on Fridays. Mm-hmm. You go on Fridays. Mm-hmm. And I remember hearing somewhere that you're restricted to just the women. You know, and not the men.
Well, I'm somewhere. Not. I mean, I can see the men, but I have. It's just typically when you're dealing with substance use, it's better if women work with women and men work with men. I'm not restricted to see the men. I have gone in to see the men, but that's only if if the guys that do the ministry need me to in the situation of maybe getting housing together, or if they're needing something for court. You know, it's very rare that I have to go see the men. Very rare.
Okay. All right. Because there's some men out here doing rock bottom or something else. Yes. But is it rock bottom?
It is rock bottom, yes.
Okay, so there it is. It's not just Stacy. There's some people.
No.
Involved. Because I know it'd be crazy. You couldn't do it all by yourself.
No.
So the people that who help you, are these former addicts and people that it was? Okay, so that makes sense. I mean, it's kind of hard for somebody to be that and never went through it.
Yes.
And so that is amazing. So you have, I wouldn't say partners, but associates that
we're
help
family.
You with it.
Okay. We're family. It's not you just partners or it. Rock Bottom is all about creating family and making people feel connected to something, like that they belong. Mm-hmm. Because people will respond to love, they will respond to kindness, they will to feeling needed.
Mm-hmm.
And it's changing their perception of themselves that, you know, God does have a plan for you. And we'll walk with you till you find out what that plan is, you know. But yes, everybody that does help Rock Bottom has had a past with addiction, because people do. One of my first questions whenever I was trying to people were trying to help me, my first question to anybody that came to me with advice was, have you ever had an addiction? Mm-hmm. And if they said no, then I would shut them down. I didn't want to hear what they had to say, because they didn't know what I was experiencing at that time.
Well, that was in love. You shut them down. You didn't just like, get out of my face.
Just being transparent again. It was not love. It was like, I need you to get out of my face. Because if you're not going to, you know, if you've never lived it, then you don't know what you're talking about. So
that's right. Save some time. We ain't going to go through all this. Just stop you right there.
Yeah, I'm just going to stop you.
Yeah. Well, that brings to mind another thought about how, well, I know it's you and you've got some other associate or family that's helping you. Now, that has to be something that's really, really tight.
Yes.
You've already established that they've had to have been, went through something.
Yes.
In order to be able to talk to you and be a part of this. Mm-hmm. There has to be an amazing, strong accountability throughout this. You know, I mean, not if you, I came to you and you found out, oh yeah, well, you used to do that. And now you're straight, you're clean. So, and I want to work with you, but there is still an accountability right there between you and I that you need to see from me. Yeah. On a regular basis.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. That makes sense to me, because you have been through so much, and it's only been what? 4 years, 5 years, 4 years,
2015, 6 years,
6 years.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That would, some people say I'm tired, you know, and I'm sure a lot of times.
No, you mean the sobriety or rock bottom? What was you asking me? I'm sorry.
Oh, that's okay. The rock bottom.
Oh, since 2017, January 2017. So, yeah, that's been a little four and a half years.
Okay. All right. 4.5 years you've done that. Now, that's a long time to do an organization. A lot of people get in organizations, they roll in, they roll out, they roll in, they roll out.
Yeah.
That's not even in sight for you. Is that in sight for you?
No.
I mean, hey, I'm in this. I'm going to do it. Because this, that you feel that this is something truly God has put in your heart and laid on you to do.
Oh, I know it. Without a doubt. Absolutely.
Now, that's strong. So, because a lot of 501c3s, you get in their organization, you work. Then, like I said, you roll off.
Mm-hmm.
That's not even in your mind.
No.
And
the only way that it would ever end is if God said it's time, you know, but I don't feel like that's ever going to happen. I mean, I'm sure that I'm not in time, but I believe that he established rock bottom to go through for as long as time exists. It will be here.
Mm-hmm. Well, okay. We're coming up on the end of our, mm-hmm. we got about maybe 8 or 9 minutes.
Okay.
I really, really would like to see. Now, you answered most of it right there. Hey, I'm focused 100%. As long as God give me breath in my body, somebody needs me, I'm there.
Yeah.
I'm there to do, especially in something that you know about, which is being addicted to something.
Yes.
And so my next question to you is that, how has this affected your family? I mean, you have... Two times you had, I was addicted. Now I'm not addicted, but I'm got this rock bottom and along with a job. Mm-hmm. How do you juggle it?
It's hard. It's really hard. You just do the best you can. And my family, they understand what I do because they lived through it. And of course they don't want another family to go through
what
they did. Mm-hmm. So they understand when I get calls in the early morning hours or really late at night, they understand why. And I do have to say though, this is not all a bed of roses. I'm cussed more times than not, pretty much on a daily basis, because you have to understand working with people that's in active addiction. You're not dealing with the person, you're dealing with the addiction.
Right.
And that's who I'm talking to. I'm talking to the addiction, not the person. So they want to tell me how I'm going to help them. And they get really upset with me whenever I don't help them the way they think I should. Mm-hmm. So that's probably the most difficult part of doing what I do, because I have to look at what I'm dealing with, and I have to put my boundaries in place and say, you know, this is what I'm offering to help you. You know, either you will accept it or you will not, because each person's different. Mm-hmm. Every person's recovery story is different. Rehab helps some people. Jail helps some people. Some people can go to outpatient programs. There's just so many facets to what it is I do, but I do have a lot of good support system behind me.
That is amazing. That truly amazing. You know, and so much so that you recently was given an award, unbeknownst to you. You didn't even see it coming.
Not a clue.
Can you tell us just a little bit? We got about 2 minutes left. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
I received the Governor's Award for Volunteer of the Year for 2021 and went to the commissioner's meeting. They were pretending that they wanted to have an update on rock bottom. And I thought that was kind of odd, but so I went and gave them my spiel, and it was just a very nice surprise. Dr. Rob Peck presented me with it, and it was really nice. I was very appreciative. It was shocking.
See, now that comes from a person who truly, truly not just loves what you do, but it is what you do. And so we want to thank you so very much here on Extreme Carolina.
Thank you for having me.
It has been our pleasure. And the folks that are on here, they're going to want to know more about this, who don't know about it. Mm-hmm. And the way that is, you guys got a website, someone they can check you guys out?
We do not. We're on Facebook page, Rock Bottom Recovery and Support.
Okay.
And because you have to maintain a website, and we don't have the funds for that.
Okay. All right. Okay.
So,
I got you.
Yeah.
So this is a way that people listening say, hey, well, maybe I can help, you know, do that, you know. And so the way you do that, contact Stacy through the Facebook page, Rock Bottom Facebook. And if you forget all that, then you won't forget me, Michael Borkman, Extreme Carolina. And you contact me, I'll contact her. So it is amazing. So thank you again.
Thank you.
We really appreciate you so very much. And I tell you what, and if folks come at me and say, well, you didn't ask this, you didn't ask that. Well, then down the road, we will come back. We'll ask you again. We'll see how you're doing, because it's been 4.5 years in and you still are doing what you do with a smile, and it is amazing, mainly because you got God. You got the ultimate support system. And we're just grateful to know you and be a part of your life and call you a friend. Thank you so very much. And it has just been amazing. So we're going to get ready to get out of here. But before we do, we're going to say a quote of the day. But before we do that, Extreme Carolina, and thank you one more time. I want to say that. Thank you, Stacey. Appreciate it. Ultimately, Extreme Carolina is committed to you, our listeners, to bring you leaders and newsmakers like Stacey here that are passionate, purpose-driven, and making a difference by listening to their stories. Extreme Carolina listeners will have an opportunity to refuel, reconnect, and get inspired by unlocking the power of the people. Here we go, folks. Quote of the week. Short, sweet, and simple. Quote of the week. Here it is. The best success stories often begin with failure. There you go. You're looking at a success that Stacey Ledford right there. God bless you, sweetie. We love you. And we look forward to talking to you down the road. Take care. We out. Peace.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Bye-bye.